there were farming, cattle raising, the growing of sugar cane, and the burning of charcoal. They were the main industry. We did not have no, and we did not have no drivable roads. So the only means of transportation they had was either to ride a horse, a mule, or a donkey. We only had track roads. Alright? This was way back then. And then the buildings that we had here, they were all wooden, as I told you earlier. So as we go along the wall, folks, this is what you're looking at. I call this wall the history wall, because it's actually giving you a little history of Rhode Island. So there you can see the people, the guys, they're farming, they're banking Tanya. Tanya grows at the bottom of the wine like a potato. So they're showing you the way in which to do it and how the ladies will carry the food for the workmen. They carry the big trees on their heads, and in their hands they carry the jug with water. Now the cows, they used to take them to the dip, and the dip was used for cleaning those animals. If you notice that black one is going in between the concrete walls, in the center of that wall is some water with chemical in it. So each one of those cows is going to jump in there one by one, and he'll swim out on the opposite end. And once they pass through the water with that chemical, the chemical in the water will kill all the ticks and insects that might be on those animals. So that is what the dip was used for. And to give them water, you can see right there, folks, the guy would have a well with a trough alongside it. He'd use a rope and a bucket to the water, and then the cows would come and drink it. The whiteboard you can see on that animal is an egret, and he also cleans the animals. He eats the ticks and insects of those animals. Now these beautiful ladies here, they are baking bong bong. This is a type of bread that was made from cassava. Once they pluck the cassava from the ground, they will peel it, grate it, and then they will sift the grated of course with other ingredients so they can make that cassava bread. And to go to the market in those days, as I said, that's how they used to do it. They carry the big trees on their heads, and they carry some of their load on a mule or a donkey. That is a mule they're using right there. And since we did not have no electricity, they had to bake their bread in an oven that was made from clay. So you're looking at a clay oven right now, folks. They put some dry wood in the oven, light them, and once the oven is heated, the lady will use a long stick with a flat end to put the bread in there so they can bake. The bands that they had in those days, they were called fungi band. No electrical instruments, all banjos and ukuleles and squash and stuff. And you also here, you can see how the way in which they used to dress and dance. You can see them right here. Now the men here, they're finished cutting the cane and they're squeezing the juice out of it so they can make rum. So those three things are squeezers, they're going to spin around while the guys put the cane there between them, and they will get the juice out of it. And once they got out all the juice, they will make the rum. And here you can see them where they're finished making the rum. And then they will store it in those barrels you can see right there. Those barrels are made from oak wood. But before they put the rum in the barrel, they will burn the inside, they will burn it. Okay? And then they will put the rum in there. The rum will stay in there for 4 years. And when it comes from the barrel, they have a dark color to it. So that will be the